Behind every great restaurant, there's an even greater chef. Over the years, Dolce Vita has visited countless exquisite restaurants. But how much do you actually know about chefs who have poured their heart and soul into creating those amazing dishes? Well, today, I'm going to spend some time with a young and talented chef who's at the helm of a Michelin-starred restaurant. Let's go meet him.
Restaurants in Central. About 8 years ago, I moved to Hong Kong, but I was actually already originally born here. Then I moved to Canada, where I grew up, eventually moved to New York to continue my career. Finally, 8 years ago, I came back to Hong Kong. I go to the market every day. Before I come to work, there's virtually never a day where I don't go to the market, whether I need to pick up something from there or not.
Go into the market every day and pick your own produce. Now, that's dedication.
I always try to use something local, but that doesn't restrict us from using only local products and produce, because I never want to limit myself as a chef. Though I am from Hong Kong, and so I'm proud of all Hong Kong products. Wherever I think the quality is exceptional or acceptable, then we will always try to use local.
I've always wondered if local seasoned produce really tastes better. Well, now I know why people love coming to the wet market.
So today, I bought many things actually. I bought a fish called Amadai, a 5-year-old Sanpei, which is a mandarin skin, in which the shop owner actually dried herself. Then we've also had some fresh longan, in which we actually have turned into a vinaigrette later into one of the dishes. Fresh flower crab from Hong Kong. So the ingredients that I choose in the restaurant is very vast, meaning there's no limit, really there's no limit, and I never wanted to limit myself as a chef. A chef is somebody who takes ingredients, whether they're beautiful ingredients or just ordinary ingredients, and turning that into something beautiful. So I like to say my relationship with this, with all of my team, really is we're one big family. Whenever I hire new staff, I'm actually just the one who signed the paper and says, okay, let's hire this person. But prior to that, before I do that, I always ask our new staff member to come in, spend a day with my whole entire team. And it's actually my team who decides whether I will hire them or not. And this is the reason why our team is so good.
There's a lot to love about this place. I like the setting, I like the ambience, and it's sort of open, but there's an intimate and warm feeling to it as well. Wow, they look incredible. I've never had something like this before. So what do we have in here?
So these are your finger snacks, and so as I mentioned, it's always Chinese inspired here in the restaurant. So starting on the left hand side, you'll find a caviar snack using Chinese caviar. And so so instead of a traditional Blinese from Russia, this is a pancake. It replaced it using steamed bun mantou.
Right.
So in it is also some steamed smoked sour cream. So enjoy in one bite.
Try this.
You also have this one, which is interesting. This is my take of Chinese steamed fish. So normally, you go to any Cantonese restaurant, you will always have a choice to steam fresh fish with sweet soy sauce, a little bit of scallion, ginger, and some cilantro. So that's exactly what that is. Only the skin of the fish is made crispy. fish itself is turned into a puree, scallion and the ginger also turned into a green puree, pickled chili. Lastly, the sweet soy is turned into a powder. You see a little powder on the top, and that's exactly what that is.
It's like a piece of art. I gotta try this.
So this one is inspired by a song by George Lamb, on Teach Her.
Yep.
So it is also a song that the only one that I ever sang for my wife. Inside this little shell, you find dried bok choy, sauteed bok choy, dried fish, and also dried fish puree. So enjoy just in one bite. And lastly, to pair with it, you find a little bit of cold jasmine tea.
Okay.
So the idea is to use sort of the slight bitterness from the tea to pair along with this first snack.
So for two consecutive years, you got the one-star Michelin recognition. How do you feel about that?
Well, I still remember the day when I received the notification regarding Michelin, that me and my wife were both so happy. Of course, Michelin was my partner, my team, and until now, I mean, this is something that we still cherish every day.
So what's next? What's your goal?
Well, like I mentioned, the goal is to truly maintain our standards, and not only that, to try to exceed what we have now, of course, but with the wonderful team that I have, and this is really, really important for me, is to be able to cook together and have all of our guests come back and try different things. And have confidence in us.
Excellent. Well, here's to a beautiful meal and a good night.
Thank you.